Good evening. I know it's been a while since the last time I streamed. I've been feeling a little under with the weather, dealing with some the flu and then some work stuff. So, good to be back. We're gonna be playing some Horizon, picking back up from where we left off last time, and having some fun. So, let's get to it. Get through this loading screen. One thing I should maybe do at some point is mod my PS4 to have an SSD. A lot less waiting. So last time we left off helping Oren find out that his sister's not really dead. So we're gonna continue, not Oren, Erend. So we're gonna continue that before getting back to the main story. Though I do think I'm gonna go pick up some of these side quests that are around just to get those off the map. I have to remember this is not Monster Hunter and I can't just jump off and survive. Alright, let's go pick up quest.
My family might still be alive, and you're going to stand here and do nothing?
Tell me what happened to your family. Maybe I can help.
By the sun, I fear they are all dead by now. I barely escaped alive. Machines. Vicious machines attacked my family's estate. Father sent me to get help.
What kind of machines? Where did they come from?
A Ravager. By the sun, how it cut down those guards, and a pack of Watchers came with it. The Sun King warned us that he could no longer protect freeholds beyond the valley, but Father never saw this coming.
Tell me more about the estate.
Yes, tell me more. Quarries,
and he's put his spoils into the estate. Fine tapestries, custom woodwork, silver fixtures.
But what about the people there?
Of course. Their lives are all that matter. My father and sister, plus a dozen guards and servants. I hope they survived.
I don't know if I feel like helping this guy or not.
I'll see what I can do about the estate.
You will? Oh, thank you. Oh, please, be careful. Those machines are deadly.
Yes, yes, I'm aware. Alright, now we're gonna fast travel back up to the upper area. Yeah, I've got enough packs. Let me go back up there, pick up those other two quests, and then get back to helping Erend. Find his Heath Star. See what you want.
You're Nora. I'm the mournful Naman. My apologies that we meet like this.
Like this?
In brief, you hold yours close, like a talisman. Wait, forgive me. You didn't come for reparations? Someone you lost to the Sunring?
No. I know about the Red Raids, but the Karja owe me nothing.
I see. Well, I could use the help of a strong-willed outlander. Then I would owe you very much indeed.
What do you need?
These people seek to honor their loved, their lost, with their own voices. Not mouthing Karja rituals to Karja stone. But there are obstacles. And while Meridian holds its breath for any disturbance, these robes only tie my hands.
If I could help, what must be done?
The first pilgrim is an Asuran who seeks to visit the Shrine of Kings on the road to the city. He waits there now, forbidden to enter by an old sun priest who suffer no heathen. This Utaru lost her companion on the edge of the jewel, at a pool where snap moths gather. The shrine was built there to ward off the machines, and its effectiveness leaves much to be desired. And the Manuk would paint a mark on the sun's climb. Call to the machine spirits, I understand. They need no beckoning. Glinthawks perch there, drawn to the spire's shining.
So clear the machines out of two shrines and move a priest out of the other.
All I can ask for is your charity and that their stories are heard.
All right.
Do what I can to help those in mourning.
To honor their memories is to honor us all.
So say we all. Go over here, pick that one up. Ooh, what is this?
Traitors let us dry for years, and now we're supposed to put down our weapons and smile?
Oi there, Outlander. Name's Vilgund. Did you come to the city looking for work?
Maybe.
Oh, good shards. Enough to buy garb more becoming of your...
Okay, stop there if you want me to hear you out.
I only meant a well-molded woman such
Stufu.
As you.
Stufu.
I heard an interesting rumor about a Banuk camp. Tame machines, the rumor said. So I hired men to investigate. Just investigate, that's all. Those Banuk are canny, too canny. I paid up front. Well, half up front. I've had no word back.
So now you're hiring someone to find the last men you hired.
They're a sunk cost. This rumor's worth more to me.
If I did look into your rumor...
You won't need to climb up the shoulders of the world for it. It's on the edge of Banuk land, beneath the anvil of the moon. And you look like you know your way around the savage east. The east. If it's true they walk among machines without fear in this camp, well... You can't miss that, can you? Payment on return.
Dude's a dick. Alright, anyway, back to Ireland. See what's going on.
Let's have a chat. No.
Greetings, Aloy. I am known as Blameless Marad. Please come with me. You're needed for an important consultation.
What do you mean? Where's Erend?
He's inside, attending the Sun King, where we should be without...
Dude, you've got a duck beak on your head.
All of these people are here to see the Sun King.
Yes, and each has come to ask a favor of him. Unpleasant, but that's politics. The Sun King is eager to meet you, the machine tamer with a curious eye for detail. It's all very intriguing.
I'm not here to intrigue you.
Too late.
First the Oseram get special treatment, and now outlanders from the savage interest could the Sun King have in her.
Damn you people. Bitches.
I've been here for 2 hours. This north goes to the front of the line.
Ignore them. Nobles are like children who whine when they don't get a second helping of dessert.
What's the Sun King like?
The most important thing is what he isn't like. His father. I think you'll find him to be a reasonable man.
Aloy of the Nora. She who sees the unseen. Welcome. It would seem you have done me a great service. Erend, tell her what you found.
I checked Ursa's tomb. You were right, Aloy. The body is missing a scar below her right knee. I gave it to Ursa when we were kids, fighting over a toy sword.
If the body is not Ursa's, then we must assume she is still alive. And I will not abandon her.
We only know she was taken, not who took her.
I can help with that. Ursa has an enemy among the Oseram. A warlord named Dervahl.
Impossible. Every clan in the claim has been hunting for him since the liberation. He has to be dead by now.
No other Oseram had the motive and ingenuity to lure Ursa into this trap. I expect to find him lurking somewhere near the border. I've already sent an agent to investigate. He'll be waiting for word from us at the marketplace in Pitchcliff.
I can't move troops to the border without provoking the Oseram. But I could send a few vanguardsmen. And perhaps an exceptionally gifted Nora as well. Erend, Marad, let me discuss it with her privately. I hate to impose further after all you've done, but this is a matter of great importance to me.
It sounds like Ursa means a lot to you.
Without her Oseram vanguard, I would not have been able to liberate Meridian and end my father's brutal reign. Since then, it has been difficult to maintain peace between our tribes. But Ursa has a way of making her people see reason. So you see, I need her back at my side. And quickly.
Who is Dervahl, exactly?
To understand Dervahl, you must first understand my father. He truly thought of himself as a sun god. His mind was broken. He believed that blood sacrifice would solve, well, everything. So he raided the other tribes for victims, especially the Oseram. Dervahl fought back. He crafted powerful weapons and rallied his people. My father responded with the ultimate cruelty. He captured Durval's wife and daughter and sacrificed them in the Sun Ring.
I'd like to ask you something about the Sundom and its politics.
By all means.
What can you tell me about the Shadow Carja? What do they have to do with Ursa?
They are remnants of my father's regime, holding out at the fortress of Sunfall to the west. Like him, they care only for domination, and seek to draw upon the power of the sun by spilling blood in its name.
What is armor?
Since Ursa helped me take this city from them, they were perfect scapegoats. Durval knew this, of course, and planned it well.
Your politics seem very complicated. The Oseram are friends, but enemies too?
I couldn't have liberated Meridian without the help of Ursa and her Oseram freebooters. Many of them have settled here. But the Ealdormen of the Oseram clans in the claim have become jealous of their success. So have many Carja nobles. It's a volatile situation, especially given the fact that my father raided the Oseram for years. Ursa helps keep the peace, promising a future.
Quite a place you've got here. You can almost see the little people below the mesa.
You don't approve? Well, I have a secret for you. Neither do I. But we must be patient. Change won't come in a single sunrise.
But will it happen at all, while men live in palaces?
It might. Eventually. If people like you help me bring it about.
They call you a sun god who killed his own father in order to unite the tribes in harmony. Is any of it true?
They say you can see the invisible, split an arrow at 50 paces, and tame machines at a glance. How much of that is true?
It's not too far off.
Well, I would like to unite the tribes in harmony, but you saw how many courtiers I have to deal with first. Maybe next week.
I need to get going.
I know. Well, they say kings should never beg. But please, help me find Ursa.
Who says that?
Well, Murad, for one. Don't hesitate to ask him or Erend if you have further questions.
Good Lord, damn, way up there. Go find Olin if he's any closer. Yeah, he's kind of on the way, so we'll go there first. Go here and double back. Do 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 do. them out. Shit. Fun. No, not to fuck up going back through the other way.
This'll help.
Thank you. Alright, there we go. Damn cannon mutilated those fuckers. Alright, let's loot all this shit.
Full already.
That worked out well.
Ready or not. Tuck that away.
All right. How do I get up in this camp, yo? Oh, right here. The poop covered landing. To tell sometimes.
This will be useful later.
This is what you intend. these ancient things back to life.
Their power serves us.
Machine demons from beneath the ground. It's a nightmare.
Nightmares, yes. The worst dreams of our enemies come true.
Not have left the focus up.
Yes, rise.
Will destroy us all.
They will only destroy our enemies and bring us back the lands that were taken.
Stop working.
Search the area. We may have intruders.
Forgive this intrusion, Aloy. You left me no choice.
Who is this?
An interested party. Now, the focuses are disabled, but I don't know for how long. The rest is up to you.
Thank you, Vazuzala. Sounds like Zavala. Sniping for days.
Okay.
Lives.
Kill her.
No, you had your chance.
Just stay out of their way for now.
Right, one more to go. Shit. Ah, shit. There we go. There we go. Let's clean up all these components.
Hear me out.
Hey, healing potions.
You came for me. I'm ready. Hear me out.
Give me a second. I want to go to loot shit.
Hear me out.
All right, we're good now. What do you have to say, Odin?
I promise. I'll tell you everything.
I know you will. The Eclipse were sent to kill me because I look like another woman. Older, maybe twice my age, short hair. Who is she?
I don't know. My focus found her image once, in the ruins at Maker's End. Maybe you can find her there.
You found her image in the ruins? How?
There was a door beside it, a kind of ancient device that contained the woman's image. My focus recorded the location. You do look like her. Is she your mother?
I'm the one asking questions. The killers who came for me at the Proving, who are they?
The Eclipse. Some kind of holy warriors. A cult of the Shadow Carja.
Shadow Carja?
Except they're not like any Carja I've known. They don't pray to the sun. They worship some kind of devil.
I'm not interested in their superstitions.
Oh, it's not a superstition. Their devil is real. It has a name, a voice. The most terrible voice. And they do its bidding.
What are these Eclipse cultists after, besides me?
They never said. But given the Carja civil war, they must want to overthrow Sun King of Ard and take Meridian back.
What do I have to do with that?
I don't know.
When they attacked the Proving, a man came for me. Tall, strong, dead eyes.
Helis.
And who is he?
The Terror of the Sun. Stacker of corpses, we Osram called him when he was the Mad Sun King's champion. If only he'd died with his king. But now he leads the Eclipse. I tell you, he's the most dangerous
man alive.
How did the Eclipse recruit you? I know they took your family hostage, but why you?
I was a scrounger, a rummager in dark places, good at what I do. I suppose they knew I would serve them well as a scout. I had taken a delve near Maker's End. When I surfaced, they were waiting. I laughed when I saw the priest, but then he showed me Helis's encouragement. I didn't laugh after that. They gave me a focus to watch my every move. I followed orders.
You had access to Meridian. Why didn't they get to Avad through you?
Too much dirt under my nails for an audience with the one true Sun King. But whatever Ursa or Aaron told me, the Eclipse heard every word through my focus. That's why I couldn't warn you. If I'd tried, they would have killed my family.
You say this devil the Eclipse worship has a name?
Hades. That's what they call it.
Hades.
Another name for it.
And you've heard it speak?
Steel to my soul. I heard. Just once, when it saw you. Such a voice. A cold, awful jangle. It scrapes your bones. It hollows your guts. A metal sound, but like nothing dug from the earth or smelted in a forge.
And what did it say?
System threat detected. Just three words. But in the voice of a devil.
Why are the Eclipse digging up ancient machines? And how do they get them to work?
I thought they wanted them for scrap, but they brought them back to life. Plugged some kind of device into the corpses so that Hades could whisper to them and call them from their grave.
I've fought that kind of machine before. Are there others?
Yes. The ones you fought today, they called corruptors. But there are others, much bigger, bristling with ancient weapons. Those they call Deathbringers. I've only seen them buried in the ground, but after today, anything is possible.
Sounds to me like they're raising an army.
If so, the world will fall. And I helped dig the pit.
Damn it, Olin.
I've heard enough. It's time to finish this.
I won't beg for my life. But if there's any mercy in you, free my family. Please.
Where would I find them?
My focus recorded the location. There are always guards there. You look like you can handle yourself.
Damn straight I can.
It will take many good deeds to make up for the crimes you've committed.
You're sparing me? After all I've done?
Yes. Forge a new life, Olin. One of better make.
Then the rest of my life will be lived in your debt.
Go to the place where your family is being held and wait for me. We'll make their lives the first ones you save.
I didn't earn this mercy, but I will die to make myself worthy of it. I will be waiting for you.
All right. So, complete opposite directions for both of them. Yay! All so I guess we're gonna go up this way. So we can ride north. We'll take this campfire, fast travel. Da boo dee, da boo da, da boo dee. Fill the medicine pouch back up. Alright, level 20. Actually, I should be able to avoid another point.
Must be where Nassan was supposed to check in. It looks like there was a scuffle here, but no body. Someone dragged Nassan off. There should be tracks. Oh, here we are. Let's see where they went.
Oh, up to this fort.
Oh boy. Shadow Carja first. Let's hope there's someone inside.
Leave me the file alone. All right. These little arrows suck anymore.
Let
Let this strike a punch for shame.
Sons of bitches.
Company, look alive!
Trouble doesn't just up and leave.
Damn her!
Let's look at what I've got in these treasure boxes. Lots of shock traps, that's great, but not useful. More wire for arrows. Campfire, that's good.
We've got Masan, all right. He needs help.
Let's try this again. I'll keep it simple since you're obviously feeble. What were you doing out by the fork?
It was a picnic.
This could be it.
Thank you.
Keep eyes out.
You bitches. Let's go save the dude. And we'll loot the place.
Kindiv sent me. Let's get you out of here.
I thought that old salt had abandoned me. Guess I owe him a slap on the back. Come on, this way.
I'm gonna loot the chest, chill the fuck out. Anything else here that I need to look at?
Dust feels like it's under my skin.
Where the fuck did he go? Yellow rope.
Kindiv told me about the cause. Did you lose the shipment?
No. It's hidden nearby. There's a lot of hungry people in Sunfall that will be happy to see it.
Good. Now, listen. When you head back to Meridian, talk to a noble named Ravon. If you're honest with him, I think he'll help.
Beg a high blood for help? Ugh. But after everything you've done, I can't refuse. But for now,
damn
I'm
right.
Back for Sunfall.
Could do it, bitch.
Be safe.
You'll help.
All right.
Baker's End. Not much farther. Olin said he found an image of the woman I resemble on an ancient device. If she's my mother, why would there be traces of her all the way out here? So far from Noraland. I don't get it. Who is she?
Her name is Elizabeth Sobek.
You spying through my focus again? Well, go on. Tell me more about her.
Stay on the present course. Before long, you'll know her as well as I do. Maybe better. But be wary. Baker's End is crawling with Eclipse troops. To help you deal with them, I've left some useful equipment just outside the ruins. Your focus will show the location.
Who is he and how does he know these things? He said Elizabeth Sobek. What kind of name is that?
You've earned the right to trust the trail. I spent some time in the wilds. I think we have that in common.
Back.
Just really kill the two Nora? That was the horse. Good.
I saw some of the places you'd been. The new settlers had no appreciation of property. They'd already piled your work in a ditch. And I knew the signs to look for. The scrabble in the dirt, those surprised splashes. And I did tell you we'd meet again.
Nil. Still hunting bandits?
Oh, yes. I've been sharpening my blade, anticipating the scent of the fight. Don't get me wrong. These scum...
You want to fix the range rolls that we have?
A little panic and desperation really sets it off, though.
Oh, then never mind.
So, what's your knife called?
Why would someone name a knife?
Oh.
So much for small talk.
Are you ready?
Just don't think this means I enjoy it.
Don't worry. We'll take your secret to their graves.
Coming down steady as a drumbeat.
See if we can get a little more wire, make some more arrows.
Save these for the trail.
Something there! No room. I'll find a use for you. Thank you.
I hear something in that grass. Nora tried to shoot me with one of those rope things once. Strung him up with it.
Yeah, I'm gonna check that out. See the alarm. Hope I don't hear it too.
Come on, patrol dude, come back up this way, we'll murder you, we'll go finish off all your friends.
Over here.
God, I wish I had wire. Dudes left.
What have they taken prisoners for? Nothing good. Are you ready to move? You're coming with me.
I
can see them. They can't see you. I think this one's dead.
Wipe those bandits out. Thank you.
The Oseram love to mine the ruins of the old ones. They even live on top of the scrap.
Remember how the blood pounded in your ears? They'll ring later, in the calm. It's a call to arms, from your inner desires.
Or a cry for help.
I wouldn't fight it.
I can tell. Have you found a new partner yet?
I thought we were partners.
I have my own roads to follow, Nil.
And they seem to lead back to bandits. That works for me. I'm not suggesting a Karja wedding. I'm never lonely where there's killing to be done.
Time to move on.
A brief encounter for us, but the end for them. They were squalid lives anyway.
XP from that.
Good for an old remedy. And there's the rain. said it would be. Not a bad selection. I'll put those to use. What?
Because I want you to succeed. Good hunting. We'll talk later.
Wait! Damn him. Watchers. Acting as guards. The Eclipse and corrupted machines. Cooperating. One happy family. The Corruptor.
Rolled into a shitstorm.
Black chopping at hard ground.
It will go quickly for you if you come out now.
Thank you. What?
What have they been uncovering here? No space. An explosion. Explosion. easier when I was a kid.
Well, that looks like fun. Wow.
Focus. Stop working.
I've disabled his focus. The rest is up to you.
I'll handle it. Steam's blasting out. I wonder if those are weak points.
Thank you.
did it. Those things. Let's see what you have to say. What? What is this?
The entity lives. Unacceptable. Unacceptable. Unacceptable.
Hades.
What the hell was that? Hades? Hey! Mysterious stranger, did you see that? No answer, huh? Figures. Things just keep getting stranger. I need to find a way inside the tower. But I can squeeze through.
Hold for identiscan. Confirmed. Entry authorized. Greetings, Dr. Sobek. Please step inside.
Maybe we'll finally get some answers.
That's hundreds of years ago. What's going on?
The protocols use polyphasic entangled waveforms, quantum encryption, black quartz stuff, way beyond military grade. That's what you demanded. So that's what we delivered.
You don't code something you can't crack. All we need is a backdoor. Upload the latest service pack update and the problem goes away.
You specifically forbade us from leaving anything resembling a backdoor in code. Every protocol to black quartz standard. Your words. Look. If you need me to fudge some projections, it's nothing we haven't done before.
I don't need fudged projections. I need a way to reassert control over the Heart's Timor Swarm.
I don't know what to tell you, Ted. You're asking the impossible.
So, codes. They needed codes of some kind to control the machines. But they got out of control. That sounds bad. Statue of one, anyway. A machine built to kill you, and they honored it.
Welcome to Feral Automated Solutions, where all the problems of tomorrow are being solved today. With over 25,000 human employees based in nations and corporate holdings across the globe, Feral leads the world in every sector of self-sustaining, fully automated technology. From revolutionary consumer products close to home, like the Feral Focus, to the dynamic chariot line of peacekeeping robots halting bloodshed in conflict zones across the globe, Feral remains committed to making the future smarter, brighter, safer.
What was this place? What were they doing here?
It was a corporation. A group of people, not unlike a tribe. And they made machines.
Yeah, go on.
I've uploaded some data files to your Focus. They'll help you understand.
Now, I know this must seem like a bizarre change in direction. I mean, we're Feral Automated Solutions, right? Number one robotics firm in the world. Why would we clear our production slate to fabricate human-operated vehicles and weapon systems, the relics of the past? All I can say at this juncture is... trust me, we will be exploiting a massive, growth opportunity by retooling and reallocating capacity according to my plan. So I will need revised projections of mass fabrication velocity across every pipeline within 36 hours.
So they were making machines, then they stopped to make another cave-in. But I could get through.
Because there's loot. If I can. Fuck.
Made it. Might need this. So, people were angry at Faro, at the corporation. They blamed this place for something. Something bad.
Seven Horus. Imagine your complete engagement ecosystem comprehensively managed by a high-speed learning machine network. Whether your need is to replace battlefield losses or intensify force projection, the Horus's onboard manufacturing capabilities mean you'll never get stuck waiting for the next arms delivery. Simply redefine your force. CA-3 Scarab combines conventional and information warfare capabilities in one package, designed for high-speed, all-terrain reconnaissance. It boasts the world's highest survivability rating of any Scout-class autonomous agent. Maybe it's the Scarab's emergency biomass conversion systems that ensure it always makes it back to base, even if fuel supply lines have been interdicted. Or maybe it's the Scarab's ability to slave enemy robots to its own network. Now that's force multiplication. Add a prehensile... The F-18 FSP-5 Kopesh provides a one-size-fits-all solution to main battle force capability. Metamaterial construction delivers unmatched recoil dampening, allowing you to field any weapon package that conforms to your budget needs and conflict resolution profile. Patented biomass conversion systems allow extended emergency operations with minimal environmental impact. Multilinear target processing provides simultaneous real-time threat analysis and legal review for autonomous domestic operations. Or control can be slaved to the swarm's neural network for weapons-free force application. Either way, when it's time to call out the big guns, it's time to call Kopesh.
The Deathbringer. So this was the heavy hitter. Main battle force indeed. Looks like the way up. What's left of it.
I'm in for days up the side of this. There we go.
Gonna be a long way up. Frozen metal most of the way. Not making this easy, Dr. Sobek. If plants can find a way to hang on up here, I guess I can too. Frost on my eyelashes.
This began when they engaged in unauthorized offensive operations against robots and human personnel of the Hearts Timor Energy Combine. Now I wish that I could relate that the crisis has been exaggerated, but it's not. The peacekeepers have not responded to stand down codes. And by all signs, they appear to be replicating at a precipitous rate. Now, what I can promise you, I can absolutely assure you, is that I am already devoting every possible resource towards reaching a speedy conclusion to this issue. So when you hear the bad talk about us against this company in the days, maybe weeks to come, just bear in mind that we will get past this. And a day's coming when none of this will matter.
Peacekeepers. That's what they called their machines. They were built for war, not peace.
Thank you.
the way up. All it takes is a few good handholds. All right, made it. Wonder what we'll find.
Elizabeth, good to, it's been years.
Where's your legal team, Ted?
No need. I dropped all 18 lawsuits the moment you landed. I assume your daddy confirms this.
All right, this promises to be interesting.
Perhaps we could have lunch brought in. You know, get reacquainted.
I know you, Ted. You've screwed something up, something big, or you wouldn't have eaten the crow necessary to get me here. So spit it out.
There's a glitch in the chariot line.
You're killer robots?
Peacekeepers, yes. Those.
So shut them down.
Obviously, Liz, we would, if we could. They're not responding.
Are you telling me a swarm has gone rogue, Ted?
It's worse than that.
Show me the data, then. And I'll take that lunch. Alone.
Ted Faro brought Elizabeth Sobeck here, but they hated each other.
Another file has been recovered.
This isn't a glitch. It's a catastrophe.
Fully aware. It's bad.
Bad?
Jesus, Liz.
It's not bad, Ted. It's apocalyptic. You built a line of killer robots.
Peacekeepers.
That consume biomass as fuel.
In emergencies.
And you made them capable of self-replication.
Limited self-manufacture controlled.
Not anymore. The glitch severed chain of command. The only nation this swarm answers to now is itself.
You think I did?
Everything else is just food. And at the rate it's replicating, Ted, it will strip the Earth bare in 15 months. We're not talking fall of civilization. We're talking extinction.
I get it, Liz. So how do I stop it while it's contained?
It's not contained. It can't be.
You know what I mean.
Right. Before the truth gets out, you mean.
Liz, I will do anything you say. Keep working it, and whatever you recommend, I'll do.
I'm gonna hold you to that, Ted.
The Faro robots threatened all life on Earth. But somehow she defeated them. The world of the old ones fell, but life went on, or we wouldn't be here.
A final fall has been recovered.
Project Zero Dawn. Jesus, Liz. There has to be another way.
If there were a nicer way to fix your mess, I would have proposed it.
But this? This? When I asked you to find a cure, I didn't expect it to be worse than the disease.
It's not, Ted. It may be grim, but it's our only chance. Now sign the proposal.
Sign it? I can't sign that.
Yes, you can.
That? Liz, I cannot in good conscience sign that.
You've got a choice, Ted.
I know.
I'm speaking to you from a VTOL en route to U.S. Robot Command. In 15 minutes, I meet with General Harris and the rest of the Joint Chiefs.
What? Are you crazy?
Now your choice is what I tell them. Sign, and I'll tell them the wealthiest corporation on Earth has guaranteed the funds necessary to build Zero Dawn. Exactly as I've designed it. Or don't sign, and I will make sure they and everyone else on this planet knows the real cause of the glitch.
Jesus, Liz. You don't have to threaten me. I'll sign.
Look on the bright side, Ted. From here on out, you get to do what you've always been good at. Footing the bill while others get their hands dirty.
God forgive me.
What made her solution so terrible? What did she do to stop the robots?
Executive access detected. Express lift opened.
This doesn't add up. Sobek couldn't have been my mother. She lived ages ago. All this searching, and I'm still no closer.
If that's your reaction to everything you've just learned? To whine like a spoiled child?
You should really try talking that way to me face to face.
As you wish. Do you really have no idea how monumental are the discoveries you just made, Aloy? I expected more of you.
So, you have a face. Got a name to go with it?
Of all the questions you could ask right now, that's the one you choose. I've spent decades searching the ruins of the Old Ones, trying to solve the mystery of what happened to them. For years, I've suspected that feral robots destroyed their civilization, but I could never confirm it. And in minutes, you uncover more ancient knowledge than I have in a lifetime, and what you want to know is my name. Silence, that's my name. Now, why don't you try asking another question? Something less trivial.
All right, Silence, you made your point. I came to these ruins hoping to learn more about this Elizabeth Sobek. And I have, but I still don't understand my connection to her. Or why the Eclipse is trying to kill me. Or who Hades is. No answers, just one question after another.
Exactly. Which is why it's time to expand your frame of inquiry. Only then will you see just how big your problems really are.
What exactly are you talking about?
You've chased a personal riddle into a crowd of larger mysteries. The common thread is your connection to Elizabeth Sobek.
But what is that connection? She couldn't have been my mother if she lived centuries ago.
We don't know the connection yet. The only way to find out is to keep going, to keep making discoveries. Thanks to you, we've only just now learned that feral robots once threatened to end life on Earth.
But it didn't happen. The Old One civilization was destroyed, but life was saved.
Obviously. So, what did Elizabeth do? How did she stop the robots before all was lost?
What was Project Zero Dawn?
Exactly the question. Now, are you ready to go get the answer?
Of course I am.
Then why are you still standing here?
Not so fast, Silence. You've got some explaining to do.
I've told you quite enough. If you've still got questions, be quick about it and stop wasting my time.
You've been using my focus to spy on me. How's that possible?
Every focus emits a signal, a voice that only other focuses can hear. I know how to string those voices together, how to make them talk to each other, to communicate, even over vast distances.
How do you learn to do that?
Years of study and experimentation. In principle, it's not so different from how you override machines. I override focuses.
And you can spy through other Eclipse's focuses, too.
Usually. All I'll say is that overriding the connections is complicated. Now, that's enough talking. Be on your way.
Oh, no. I'm just getting started. You've been getting a free ride on my Focus, risking nothing while I risk everything. All I have to do is take this thing off my head, and you'll be blind, deaf, and dumb. So quit complaining and answer my questions.
Very well. Proceed.
Who are you, Silence? And what are your intentions?
You really need to make this personal?
Come on, answer the question.
He left his tribe behind a long time ago. An explorer of forbidden places, a searcher of lost knowledge. Exactly as I said.
Why do you know so much about the Eclipse?
I happen to know a lot about a lot of things. If what you're really asking is whether I work for the Eclipse or anyone else, I don't. I am nothing if not independent.
You said you've known for some time that Faro war machines destroyed the civilization of the Old Ones.
The evidence pointed that way. But until now, I never knew the full scope of their danger. That they could process organic matter into fuel, or that the Horus class could manufacture more robots. Like a cauldron on legs.
But the robots we've seen so far, the Corruptors and Deathbringers, they don't do those things.
Not yet, anyway. So far, we haven't encountered any that are undamaged. At full power, who knows what they're capable of.
So far as I can tell, the Eclipse are just following orders. It's Hades who wants me dead. Who is he?
I don't know. The Eclipse describe him as a buried shadow, some kind of devil.
That thing that spoke to me outside, that made that Focus explode. That was Hades. It didn't seem like a person or a machine. More like a phantom. It's a terrible voice.
All that's certain is that he wants you dead.
Because of my connection to Elizabeth.
You fail, so...
Hades is using the Eclipse to resurrect the robots.
But if Elizabeth found a way to stop them centuries ago, if she made special weapons, maybe Hades is worried I'll do the same thing.
In some of the ancient data I've recovered, there are hints of so-called super weapons being developed. Maybe to stop the robots, the civilization of the Old Ones had to destroy itself.
Is there any chance that Elizabeth Sobek could still be alive somehow?
It's highly unlikely, but not impossible. Some of the ancient data I've recovered includes mentions of life extension techniques. Pharmaceuticals, mostly, an ancient word for medicine. But some were still trying to perfect ways of freezing and unfreezing people.
Freezing and unfreezing people?
Cryogenics, they called it. But there were problems with it. Given Elizabeth's technological acumen, I can't definitively rule out that she found a way to make herself immortal. But this is speculation, wasting time.
Elizabeth told Ted Faro she was headed for a place called U.S. Robot Command to tell people about Zero Dawn.
The place still exists as a ruin. The Aseram call it the Grave Horde.
Grave Horde? Cheery name.
You'll find it in the Eastern Mountains, buried under the tangled coils of a metal devil, or a BOR-7 Horus, rather, as we're learning to call them. I'll contact you when you get there.
I can't wait. Someday we'll meet in person, and your manners had better be improved. Well, getting down will be a lot faster than getting up here, at least. U.S. Robot Command next. To learn the secrets of Zero Dawn.
Thank you.
The snow's got a bite out here. Ouch.
So we'll go see what Aaron's up to, and then probably call it. But I tell you that we're kind of through Act 2 now of the story. Pay me no mind.
Gonna need this.
Another cauldron.
Can override them if I don't spook them.
Fight each other. And we'll be running this way.
Keep quiet now. Helpful.
Get a better bow.
Should have brought a cart.
Really? I'm out of resource space? Fuck. Can I... Resources... Two more bones. I mean, what do I need that much freaking wood for?
Never know when I might need these.
This must be Pitchcliff. Murad's agent should be at the marketplace by now.
Sign of Murad's guy. He's had plenty of time to investigate.
We'd better look for him.
Damn right.
Let me sell some shit first. Alright.
Well, someone left here recently, and they were in a hurry.
Has to be Murat's guy. Durval's thugs must have made him.
Maybe because he found something. Look at this. I think he drew a map with his own blood.
Right. Those kind of maps, you know, you better follow.
That might be Pitchcliff. He marked a spot to the north. Could be Durval's location.
And my men are waiting outside of town. I'll grab them and meet you there.
Can't go. machines. Looks like they've been chained up.
Durval's a tinker. He probably experiments on them or strips them for parts.
Maybe I can use them to make some trouble. I'll go in first. Hold off until the fighting starts.
All right. We've got your back.
All right, let's go start some trouble with these. Guys left up over there. Mom, pop your head up so I can snipe you, you son of a bitch.
Thank you.
Definitely not scrap.
See what happens when you pick a fight with the Vanguard!
Ursa must be around here somewhere. Let's find her.
Loot all the bodies.
Val says you gotta eat dirt.
I take you out, buddy.
Ursa must be in there. We have to get through.
The damn chicken.
they must use these to protect themselves from that awful sound.
Finally.
Durval tried to break me. Shows what he knows.
I should have been with you. Why didn't you come for me? I know I'm a useless trunk, but...
No, idiot. I got a message from Durval saying he wanted to parlay. I didn't come for you because I knew it was a trap. I couldn't let you get hurt. Just didn't think it'd be that good a trap. Thought I could take him out. Now listen. Durval's planning something big in Meridian. He said he'd force Avad to watch as the smoke darkens their precious sun. Your king needs you. No more playing around. You're gonna have to grow up fast.
I will. I promise.
You damn well better, little brother.
No.
Ursa. No, no. Please.
Just rescued you. You're not supposed to die.
Aww.
Fuck.
I promise.
All right, well, let's loot the workshop. Hurry up. Loot, loot, loot.
I'm so sorry.
You've got to find Durval. But Meridian's a big place.
I'll look through his things. Maybe we can narrow it down. Such a strange device.
That sound
it's
is so funny.
This machine is
sound?
With precision.
It's like one of those rain sticks, but like the kitty teeth version. Where you flipped it over to make that sound.
What? What noise?
Boing. Your computer keeps doing it.
This noise? That's
sounds like that thingy, like the kid thingy that like has the whistle in it.
What happens
no.
When I turn it off? Oh, well, that's what it sounds like.
That's when I activate my focus.
Oh, cool.
I think I've got it working. There. Now.
Just notes about crafting and a letter tucked between the pages. Lots of blaze headed to Meridian. If we find it, I'll bet we find our vault too. I think I found something that can help. Let's head back to the palace.
Go. I won't be long, but I need to tend to my sister.
Alright, so we're gonna go to a campfire near the palace, and then we're gonna save. And that's where we're gonna call it for tonight, but we'll pick it back up probably tomorrow or Thursday and save Meridian and then onward to US Robot Command. So thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed.